Hello, this is Mrs. Meckins, and we're starting a new skill series. Now I want to teach you how readers can track an idea. Okay, let me explain what tracking is by comparing it to something you already know about and show you how they're just a little different. Okay, so you remember when we learned about retelling and summarization? And remember we compared summarization to ESPN SportsCenter? And I said you could watch the whole game for 2 hours. You could listen to the whole play-by-play of the two-hour game. That would be a retelling, right? Or a paraphrase. Or you could summarize it by watching the 4-minute version on SportsCenter the next morning. And remember, the summary was shorter, yes, but it included only the most important information from the beginning, middle, and end. Okay, that's a summary. What we're learning in this lesson is not how to summarize, how to track. Okay, they're similar but different. Okay, and the idea here is that you are still going to collect details from across the whole text. Tracking means look across the whole, track from beginning to end, all right? Like tracking an animal from the time you see the first track until you find the animal, all right, if you're hunting. And so this idea that you track from beginning to end, it's the whole text. It's still the whole text. But now we are not going to look at only the most important information. When we track all the way across the whole text, but now we're looking at all of the details, not just the most important, all of them. Any detail we can get, like any footprint we can find, we're going to grab it, we're going to note it, we're going to remember it, all of the details across the whole text. Well, Mrs. Meckins, wait a minute, isn't that what a retelling is? Isn't that a paraphrase? Yes, it is, except I want to add one more difference. When you track, you look across the whole text, gathering every detail you can, but only for one facet, only for one idea. Let's go back to ESPN SportsCenter. If we watch the summary the next morning of just the highlights, we're going to learn about the whole game, beginning, middle, and end, but not all the details. We're going to learn just the most important details, beginning, middle, and end. And they're going to tell us about all of the important plays, all the important characters or athletes, all the important information scores. We're going to get all of the most important across the whole text. What if on ESPN SportsCenter, they didn't tell you about all of the important players and all of the big plays? What if they only told you what one athlete did the whole game? They told you what that athlete did in the beginning, first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, told you every detail about one athlete, whole game. That's what tracking is. Tracking happens after you finish reading. You don't track while you read, you track after you read. So you read, okay, and then you do a summary. You have to understand the gist, the overall most important information. Then when you track, you go back to the text again. You reread. You do. You reread. And you zoom in and you look. It's like a spotlight. You only look at one element, one facet, one thing, beginning, middle, end, and you collect all the details. All right. So the difference between tracking and summarization is that it's a lot of details, not just the most important, but it's only for one idea, one facet. Okay. So I could tell you, I could track all of the information about a single character. There might be five characters, but I'm talking about one character. Or I can tell you all of the details and track the setting. What was the setting in the beginning? What do we know about the setting in the middle? What do we know about the setting at the end? Or the plot. I could tell you as soon as we get the problem, forget the character, forget the setting. I only track, zoom in, spotlight, only track as soon as we have a problem, what makes the problem worse, how does the problem climax, and how do they solve it? Boom, that's it. I track all of the information just about the plot, problem, solution. You see what we're doing? We're zooming in. That's tracking. And it's kind of an after reading skill. First, you have to be able to just summarize each of the big things to then zoom in and look at just this one factor, this one facet. Okay, so now you can track one idea from nonfiction, okay? An event, an important person in a social studies text. You could track just one thing in nonfiction. You could also just track in literature, just one story element, just the setting, just the character, just the plot, just the theme, that kind of a thing. Now, in this lesson series, we don't have time to learn how to track everything, all right? So we're only going to work on tracking characters in fiction. That's all we're gonna do, okay? It's gonna take us several lessons, but that's all we're gonna do is learn how to track characters in fiction, how to collect all of the details about one character across the whole text, okay? That's what we're learning how to do. Now, let's talk about why you would ever wanna know this. Why would a reader need to know how to do this? Okay, because authors develop characters. They sprinkle details about their characters throughout the whole text. And they expect readers to be picking up on these details, creating a more vivid picture of the character, better understanding the character. And so the idea is that as writers sprinkle, they're developing the character, and readers need to collect all of the details, track and collect all of the details to help them better understand who is this character? Why did he do what he did? How's he feeling? What does this mean? What did he learn? This is a harder skill than summarization because you got to go right back into the text looking only for certain things. And then ultimately, we got to think about them and think, why did the author develop him like that? Why do we need to know this? What's his point? What's the author trying to tell us? Okay, we'll get to all that later. Let's just get good at tracking a character, all right? Collecting details about a character, which kind of leads me to my next point here, and that is that how do you go about tracking a character, and what do you track about a character? Okay, well, first, I think the easiest thing in terms of a tool for tracking is to just use like a timeline. Just a timeline. Tell me everything you know about this character from beginning, middle to end. So, I mean, seriously, it could just be a piece of paper where you just kind of have a beginning and an end. And you tell me he did this and he did this and he did this and I know this and here's another detail and here's another detail and here and da, 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 beginning to end. And I'm tracking. You see how they look like footprints, right? 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 Isn't that what we do when we're when we're taking notes? We're collecting the details, right? One footprint after another. Authors are sprinkling one detail after another, developing a character. By the end of the text, we need to collect all of the details about this one character. All right? That's what we're working on, is characters. And so you could just do it in a timeline from beginning to end, just in order. Now, I'm going to use this kind of prettier looking timeline here, but it's the same thing. This is what happened. This is what happened. Beginning, middle, 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 end. All right. And you can see that it's moving toward the right there. And so this notion that we're just going to take notes. So now let's remember how we take notes. Remember when we take notes, what are we writing down? We're writing down actual words, details we get from our reading voice. Okay. That our thinking voice says, hey, that's important. You should write that down. And remember, we don't write down sentences when we take notes, right? It's abbreviations, it's phrases, it's just keywords, all right? So we're not rewriting the story. We're just taking notes on every detail that we learn about one character from beginning to end, all right? That's what we're doing. So what do you take notes on? Like, what do you look for in a character? What are details that will help you track and figure out how the author developed him? All right, there's several kinds of details. I only want to teach you one in this lesson. And the first kind of detail you want to look for and collect everything you can about is what a character does. Okay, you see it's green, right? Because these details are going to come through with your reading voice. Your reading voice is going to read and is going to read things about the character that the character does. Actions! And you want to take note of those. Okay, so let's look a little more closely at my stick guy here. See his kind of shaky arms, all right, because it's action, all right? So things he does. So this is physical things he does. He climbed, he jumped, he fell. This is he cried, he laughed, he screamed. So it's physical actions, things you can actually see and act out, okay? But it's also going to be actions that are less physical and they're more mental. And they're in the form of decisions, choices he makes. He made the choice to do that. He made the decision to do that. So part of do actions isn't just physical things, but it's also mental choices and decisions. Okay, so we want to take note of those. So physical actions, mental choices, and also reactions. Not just what he does, but how he responds to other people, how other people respond to him. What do they do when he does that action? Other people think what about him? All of this is going to help us better understand this character, track this character, okay? All right, so let me show you what this would look like in action. And I'm going to use a passage we haven't read before, and it's called Charles, okay? And if you just kind of look at the screen for a second, you see how that first part has kind of a triangle, okay? And then you have a line and another triangle. Okay, so that first chunk is here, okay? And then that second chunk is here, and then it keeps going, and there's a third chunk and a fourth chunk, okay? And so we want it beginning, middle, end. It's a timeline, all right? So you want to keep the chunks together, all right? So I'll do it first, and I am only going to track details about one character because you can only look at one facet at a time. And I'm going to look at Lori. Now, Lori sounds like a girl name, but it's actually, this is an older story. It's a boy name. I know it's a boy because in the first five words, it says, the day my son Lori started kindergarten. All right, so I know it's a boy. It's her son. All right, so I know it's called Charles, but I'm going to track details about Lori. What details? Only what Lori does. All right, and I'll start it, and then I'm going to ask you to help me. Okay, so I'm going to take notes. What am I taking notes on? Actual words and details the author gives me. That's what we're looking for. That's what readers write down. Actual reading voice details. Let me put that up here. This is what we're looking for. This is the kind of detail we're looking for. All right, so here I go. I'll zoom in so you can follow along. Start here in this top left. The day my son Lori started morning kindergarten, he came home for lunch and spoke insolently to his father. Okay, let's stop. Let's stop right there. And so he started morning kindergarten. My thinking voice is saying that's something he did. He went to kindergarten. He's doing kindergarten. That's an action. So now I just jot down. Now I like to write do, okay, because this is an action, okay? So I'm about to tell you something that he did. He started kindergarten. So I'm going to write that down, started kindergarten, okay? But remember, as a reader, we don't just read the words, we think about them. So that tells me he's like five. He's about five, maybe four, but he's probably about 5 years old. So I'm going to write 5 years old. And remember, because that's my thinking voice, I'm going to put it in parentheses. I'm not writing sentences, people. All right, abbreviate kindergarten. Let's just keep this zippy. All right, it's note-taking. All right, so here we go. Let me go back to my reading voice. How was school today? I asked, elaborately casual. All right, he said. Did you learn anything? His father said. Lori regarded his father coldly. I didn't learn nothing, he said. Anything, I said. Didn't learn anything. The teacher spanked a boy, though, Lori said, addressing his bread and butter. For being fresh, he added with his mouth full. Okay, let's pause there. Okay, so he's speaking to his father coldly, all right, and I didn't learn anything, and he's telling this story about a kid getting spanked, okay? He's addressing his bread and butter. That's fancy for he's buttering his bread, all right? He's putting butter on his bread. So that's a do, isn't it? He's buttering his bread. Yeah, so do butter the bread, Okay. I also found out in that same general area that he was fresh, he being Charles, all right, the boy he's talking about. And the teacher spanked him. And so the idea that he did all this with his mouth full. Lori was telling this story with his mouth full of food, of bread. Bread, he buttered his bread, talked with mouthful, okay, or full of food or something. Okay, now wait a minute. Remember, don't just collect details. Think about it. What is this telling you about the character? Well, I'm thinking Lori's kind of gross, all right? He doesn't have table manners. So I'm adding gross in parentheses. See what I'm doing? So I'm just reading and I'm looking for things that this character, Lori, does. All right, help me with this next part. All right, let's keep going. Down here on the bottom. The teacher spanked him and made him stand in the corner. He was awfully fresh. What did he do? I asked again, but Lori slid off his chair, took a cookie, and left while his father was still saying, "See here, young man." Okay. So let's think about what's happening. Okay. So we were learning about Charles, the bad kid, got spanked. Okay. The mom asked, "What did he do again?" And Lori never answered. What did Lori do? What's your thinking voice telling you Lori did? Last paragraph we read. Slid off chair, took cookie, and left. And what was the dad doing? What did the dad say at the end there? He said, "See here, young man." How do you suppose he's saying that? He says, "See here, young man." He's like telling him not to leave the table, right? He's in the middle of eating and he just left without permission. All right, so slid off chair. Okay, took cookie, left. Okay, what is this telling you? What's your thinking voice telling you about Lori's actions? We wrote down his actions, but what's it telling you about him? Yeah, he's kind of misbehaves, right? All right, so I'm writing that misbehaves, okay, after the do, and I'm putting that in parentheses because that's my thinking voice. See what we're doing? All right, let's do one more. Let's keep going. All right, but do you see how I got to my triangle here? So that means start the next chunk. So jump to the next box. All right, here we go. The next day, Lori remarked at lunch. So he went to kindergarten, he got home, and it's lunchtime now because he just goes in the morning. Lori remarked at lunch as soon as he sat down. "Well, Charles was bad again." He grinned enormously and said, "Today, Charles hit the teacher." All right, let's stop. What is something that Lori did? He's talking at lunch, told us about Charles, and what did he do? He grinned enormously. Yes. All right, so I'm going to write down do because that's an action. All right, and I'm just writing down grinned enormously. I used the actual words from the text because my reading voice told me that. And if I'm having a thought about it, I'll put it in parentheses if my thinking voice is telling me. Okay, what we're starting to learn, we're just starting this, you guys, is to learn how readers track all of the details about one character, one facet, okay, one character. And we're just starting the beginning of the story, but we would have to do it for the whole story, across the whole text, all right? The rest of the middle and the end. If you were in Mrs. Smeckin's class, what I would ask you to do at this point is read, just read. Remember, you can't do this until after you've read. So just read the rest of this story about Charles, all right? The bad kid, all right? And so far we've read the first chunk and we just started the second chunk, all right? It's a fast read, but there are five chunks. So it's two pages. There's your third chunk, fourth chunk, fifth chunk. Okay, so just read, okay? And I'm telling you, you're going to want to find out about this Charles kid, all right? You got to keep reading. But then if you were in Mrs. Smeckin's class, what I would ask you to do is track all of the details, not about Lori, no, about Lori's parents. See, it says parents. I want, using the same chunks, first chunk, second chunk, third chunk, fourth, I want you to track everything his parents do. Remember, any action, any decision, any choice, any reaction, anything they do, I want you to jot that down for the parents. Track the parents from beginning to end. You know what? I'm having a thought. Let's not do the parents. Let's do just the mom. Because parents is two characters, right? Mrs. Smeckins is just realizing that. So let's track just the mom. All right, I'll change your handout so it doesn't say parents, it just says mom, and I want you to track everything she does from beginning to end. If you were in Mrs. Smackin's class, that's what we'd be doing, but your teacher might have a better idea.